Why'd you fall so with me? You know you have no power over me. I get on your nerves, so I twitch. My friends call me bitch, but that's okay, cause I'm your bitch. I'm the rich bitch, and I got money, money I got. She likes me a lot. Inside, I could put you to joy. I get up, I can push you, you boy. If I find out you're not the only one, I'm not sure you look like. You're gonna want to take my clothes off. If you dare to take a
clothes. Music got a life form of its own. And really, I don't think we have much control over it. It's not as much as we think we have.
If someone's real and totally honest, they'll make a good album. It's just being real. Someone who's pretentious is not going to make an album that's going to touch your soul. Music's the only thing I can do. If I could make money by being a villain, being a tough guy, I would probably, because that's all I'd know and it'd be easy. So I can't do that because I'm no good at that. You know what I mean? I ain't got the nature of, and I ain't got the anger in me, really. And it's the only thing I could do. It's a thing that's been with me since I was young, and it took over all that, selling bits of weed, thiefing, just took over my life.
One, two, one, two.
They used to call me Tricky Kid. I lived the life they wish they did. I lived the life they wanna call. Now they call me Superstar. I keep disturbed, I'm aware. Everybody wants to know what my mama did. I tell you everything, tell you lie. Look deep into my mama lies. Everybody wants a record deal. And everybody wants a. And everybody wants a record deal. Everybody wants me naked and famous.
Naked and famous.
Everybody wants to be naked and famous.
Naked and famous.
And everybody wants to be just like me. I'm naked
and famous. Check it.
My dreamer still is done.
It just needs to be signed. That's it.
It's very nice.
Fucking hell, it's done.
And everybody got a record deal. Everybody wants to be naked and famous. Everybody's got a record deal. Everybody wants to be naked and famous.
Naked and famous.
Everybody wants to be just like me. I'm naked and famous. Everybody wants a record deal.
Everybody.
And everybody just wants to be like me. I'm naked and famous.
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 I haven't had the time to adjust to become a superstar, which I don't really want to be. I mean, there's nothing real about being on stage. There's nothing real about kids screaming at you. You know what I mean? It's, TV's not real, the magazine thing is not real. It's not real life, that's not how people live, you know what I mean?
I can vibe to anything, so I have to hide from everything. Everybody want a piece of me. The origin and cease to be. Forget the punk, I pack the funk. I'm gonna take a piece of you, making money for good health. But first I learn to see myself. But first I learn to see myself.
Welcome to the school, Mr. Adrian Thorns. And thank you very, very much indeed for coming in to see the kids.
No problem at all.
How long is it since you've been here?
14 years.
14 years.
Got to be 14 here. Years. I'm nervous, man. So you're the music teacher?
Yeah.
Who wants to make, who's gonna make a song then? Please? QI20 basically is like, it's a sequencer. So you can't sample on it, but it's like, imagine a keyboard with hundreds of different sounds. And basically, it's just like, it's simple as using a tape machine.
Press record there, and you press play, right? It gives you a clank. And I don't even worry about the bars and all that stuff. And I think, personally, if you're getting music lessons and they tell you you've got to be on the one bar, don't take any notice of that. That's just all rubbish.
Hesitation is a good thing in music, I think. I mean, it's a good thing. So it's, that's because I don't do it on the one of things. That's why I like the QI20 as well, because you can keep all your mistakes and it really don't really matter.
See, you're like me.
I like that. Chaos. Chaos. Music got his own life anyway. Do you know what I mean? Like, say you got a drum sound. You listen to it long enough, and you smoke enough weed, and it changes anyway. Do you know what I mean? And then it starts talking to you, and it'll tell you a part, a musical part. Yeah, have a melody.
That's wicked.
See, I don't think artists have control of the music. Like when people say things like genius, I don't think anybody owns it. It's a gift.
If that little bit put you off, say the bit, because it goes, it's a melody up until it goes a bit strange, right?
Yeah.
If we were in a studio, we could take that out and just leave this. And even the end's wicked. Wicked.
Especially when you got them in nowadays and they got to grow up in these times, man. You're fucking wicked.
What's your name?
Adrian. Fools. You ain't gonna take it off me, right? Quick, yeah. We got protection, security.
I'll tell you what, I wouldn't like to be young now. Like, I wouldn't like to be 15 now. No way. 15 now. When I was 15, I was having so much fun.
And my family come here, my uncles. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, you gotta look after me, security, like you lot.
I tell you what, at 15, I thought the other day, right? I wouldn't know where to get cocaine at 15. You've got no chance. At 15, I would never know where to get smack, cocaine, any of those drugs. I wouldn't know where to get it. The most I could get when I was younger was a bit of cess, a bit of weed, not even chemically grown, like, cess, lovely.
I smoke weed every day, right? Having paranoia in your mind every day cannot be good for you. I can't give a fuck what anybody says. I need it. It's an addiction. I need it. I have to have it. That's a tree up there. We're gonna have a fight. Oh, they've closed it off. They closed it off. What's happened there?
Grandmother's mother. Me, my Uncle Tony, my sister, my Uncle Tony's mum. So that's like four generations in the same house. And there was ferrets in box, in like cages, rabbits hung up on the wall. My granddad used to sell rabbits. You know, that's good food, you know. His brothers were all boxers and stuff like that. He was a champion fist fighter of the Northwest. My great-grandmother was the first mixed-race person in the West. Uncle Tony reckons it is American Indian. When I look at my hands, my arms here, that always reminds me of my great-grandmother. Look at these, because she had thin arms like this and tattoos. And she had mum on her hand, mum, dad, and something else. You know what I mean?
What have you got on your arm, man?
Psychic drawing. It's a guy, he says, he starts a line. You talk to him for an hour, smoke a weed with him. And then he says, I'm gonna start a line, and then you tell me when you want to stop, and I stop like up here. It's instinct. That's my soul.
I stand firm for a soil. Liquor, I come forth. And they juicy, juicy. Trust me, justice, this. Hands round the corner where I shout. is up in the schism. Living out of style, if you believe or deceive, common sense says shouldn't you see? Let me take you down the corridors of my life. And when you want to, you want to your preference.
I grew up in a family where you never see one race of people. You see white people, you see people who ain't quite black, you see people who are very black, you see people who are very white, you see people who are very yellow. You know what I mean? And it's like, and you just get called packies, you know what I mean? We're mongrels, right? But you know they say in the litter of puppies, the mongrel is the most intelligent. We're totally a mutant race. You know what I mean? We're so fucked up. And I think that aids us brilliantly. All the people in my family are successful. It's the mixed race of blood. I think we're open-minded. You know what I mean? Like Tony. He's the best fucking, one of the toughest guys I've ever seen. You know what I mean? Wild. Martin was a top gangster. Everybody in the family is kind of successful.
My grandfather was a horse dealer. And he had land in Bristol, you know. And he used to buy horses from Ireland and bring them over and sell them, you know. There was quite a lot of brothers. And they was known as like a rough family in Bristol because the way they lived.
My mum and my dad made a record in the Empire Theatre when they was young. They made a record. So don't think you're the only one.
Did they?
There was only one off, yeah.
She used to play the spoons.
Yeah, and she used to play the spoons and that, but they made used to sing lovely together, they had lovely voices. Then I was on the stage with Randolph Sutton. I was playing in the old theatre with him in Babes in the Wood. I was the leading chorus girl. Yeah. You turns after me for all this music. Because I was on the stage and I could have gone farther than you. I could.
Struggling. Look at this. Oh, that's not the one. There's Mike, the only one with a crazy little boy. Yeah. Looks a bit like you there, skinny face. Do you reckon? Small face. You went into a club in support. He wasn't involved in a fight. They wanted to charge him £1. And like he knew everyone there, and he said, no way. And it was a little posse group, I don't know who they were. And Mike had just had one tiny stab wound, but it killed him.
They say I'm insane.
How's your hands now? Because the thing I remember about you is you had terrible eczema, didn't you?
Oh, mine's, yeah, they're gone.
Yeah.
Tattoos, man.
And you used to say, I can't do PE, I can't have a shower because my hands are broken.
It's true, though, isn't it?
Oh, I don't know. I think you did it on purpose, just get up PE, really.
This place used to make me shake in my boots.
Didn't we have our last year thing in there? When you cut, and then end of the year.
Big black curtain, little stage.
Why did you particularly want to see the sports hall?
I remember the old school.
Yeah.
I waited for like how many years?
Yeah. I don't know. Two? The rest of the time you knocked off.
It's because of you. I could get a good teacher, see? Nowadays I'll be coming every day.
Now
especially while you're retiring.
Now you'll be unpleasant.
Questions that I need to know, how you could ever hurt me so. I know
every time. All Saints with the dynamic debut album, featuring the smash hits I Know Where It's At and Never Ever. All Saints, the album, out now.
Yeah, my dad thought I was crazy.
My first car was a 57 Chevy. The car eating thing, it was by accident. You know, suddenly I was a hero in this little town. I got to the point where I had a sponsorship with advertising. I had a TV show they were talking to me about. Then I discovered this new Maverick bar with biscuit, toffee, raisins, and caramel covered in chocolate. I haven't eaten a car since. Fills you up like a Dodge. Tastes as good as a 66 Mustang.
Wow.
Toyota Corolla, the car with the big following.
Ambassadors' receptions are noted in society for their host's exquisite taste that captivates his guests.
好吃极了!
Ferrero Rocher, a taste sensation, rich, luxurious, unique.
Excellente.
Monsieur, with Ferrero Rocher, you're really spoiling us.
Ferrero Rocher, a sign of good taste.
98% of Man United fans have never been to Old Trafford.
I tell you what, who's making the music? Him or the kids?
That's whoa.
You know, it's not their music, because he's not letting them write. He's writing his music.
Really?
Well, that's true. But I mean, if you take that to say painting,
I suppose it's
if you
learning.
Take that
yeah,
to painting,
yeah, I see.
You know, yeah. The kids only paint what they want to paint. They never progress, do they? You know, you have to follow examples in some way.
Yeah, I suppose. Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know
much about teaching. But it just seemed like to me that guy was saying, you play this, boom, 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 boom. You play this, boom, 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 boom. I said to her, is that what you want to do, though? Is that what they want to do? But I don't know about teaching, so I might be wrong. But that just seemed pointless. That just upset me.
I can't breathe. And I can't see. MTV moves too fast. I refuse to understand.
Individualism. If everyone were like everyone, what would we have? A community of nothing. I would love like you, hate, kill, destroy like you. I suppose it would be nice for everyone to love and not hate, but that is not life. We all feel different. A thing I would look at and say, perhaps a sculpture, and say it was beautiful. Then perhaps another man would say, oh, how obscene. That's what makes life and people so interesting and unpredictable. I am an individual. I want to remain so.
she lived with us from a baby, I think, in Padstow Road, to about 11, 12. But she was the brainy one of the family. She could write poetry like nothing on this earth, you know? And she was the first one to ever mention Shakespeare to me, and I read all his poems after that.
Maxine liked to shock. She was before her times. And you see, what you have to understand is Maxine, before she was a bad epileptic, she loved to live. She enjoyed life. She just enjoyed life. Adrian's very much like her.
She's a real straight kid, really loving kid, and not a bit of arm in her. Then she met this Roy, and that was the end of it, because he was no good whatsoever, you know. She loved him, she really loved him, really, really loved him, and he was messing all the time on different women.
He still doesn't.
And she couldn't take that.
Each time she had a baby, you know, she seemed to have more fits, and that depressed her very much.
She was a beautiful, beautiful girl. Beautiful. She'd come up my mother's in her best clothes. And my old lady said, what are you going like that? And she just said, no, just, you know, laughing and joking. Visited Marlo, laughing and joking, went to her flat, led with all her best clothes on the bed and killed herself.
She makes me wanna die. Follow where Mary goes. Cherish the things she knows. Says if I change my stride, then I'll fly. She makes me wanna die.
It was a thing of his mother dying, the doctor said, the shock of his mother dying, that's when he developed asthma.
Change my stride.
So the doctor told me, he said, the best thing to do is go and tell him that his mum's dead. So, because he was very close to his mum at 4 and a half, he was like a little old man. So I came home and I told him, like, his mum was dead, and I said, she's up there with the angels because she had a lot of pain. And every morning he used to get up, I had a thing on my windowsill, and he used to stand up there and look up, and he used to say, good morning, ma'am, every morning. But that's how his asthma first came on, he wasn't born with it.
I've always had this thing about me, mum, see that? I've always had this, I don't know what it is. Perhaps it's not knowing her really, do you know what I mean? But I feel like I still have a relationship with her almost. Do you know what I mean? I write songs, do you know what I mean? I don't know what it is.
Who do you think you are? You're insignificant. A small piece of ism. No more, no less. You try to learn the universe and can't even converse in universe. You know.
So I got asthma. Perfect excuse not to go to school. Yeah. My nan used to keep me up all night watching TV, like watching old school horror movies, like the Dracula films, and you know all those old, really old horror movies. So I was too knackered to go to school anyway. So thank God, that's why I still got my instinct, because of my nan not sending me to school, which is fucking good, man. And she taught me to pinch and she taught me to fight. She showed me one day at Buttons, because I was crying for these sweets. She never had no money, and she went in and she dipped these sweets. And she showed me, she's the first person to show me how to make a fist. As well, you know what I mean? ISIS, that's what I used to do, ISIS. I wonder if I this could get me in trouble, because I've done hundreds of ISIS, and I've never ever been caught. Most kids want a Mercs,
yeah.
Cool chains, and a house. All I wanted was a bag of weed. If I had a bag of weed, and my girlfriend, see, Alice Parham, this is the reason I never carried on thieving. I reckon Alice Parham, right? When I was going out with this girl, that's all I needed in the world. I didn't need anything. I didn't need no money. I didn't need to go out to clubs. I didn't need anything.
Who
And just read that story. What's that story? About the mongoose.
Oh, and it fights us. Yes, about the, for the jungle book.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
Was it Rikki Tikki Terry?
Yeah, Rikki Tikki Tavy.
Rikki Tikki Tavy. Yeah. I said, love that story. It was that room there.
It was this room.
Or, yeah,
it was this room here. That's right, yeah.
I feel strange. Yeah.
How do you think I feel 20 years on?
It's strange, isn't it?
It's funny you should remember that story.
Yeah, I remember that story, yeah. I remember you very well. Very, very well. I think I had a little crush on you. Is this where the headmaster's office used to be? Hello, how are you going?
How
are you going?
You remember Mr. Young? Can you remember what he taught you?
God.
Nothing. This
do you remember what you taught
him?
No. It would have been maths.
Maths. Yeah. See, that's what I didn't remember.
When's the last time you were back in Knowle West?
God. I come back about 3 years ago. Yeah. But my family still live in Arcliffe and things like that. I've still got friends there. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? I've actually got I've just signed a kid from Knowle West on my label.
Have you?
Yeah, he went to school. Yeah. Scott Purnell.
Went in the army.
Yeah, went in the army, yeah. Well, he's on the label with my cousin Mark. He went to Arcliffe School. And the other cousin from Manchester.
But one of the great things from our point of view of your visit is that we need to get as many people from the school who are now very successful. Because now you're seen as a god, aren't you? You're seen as that sort. You're up there with the
I'm
greats.
Seen as a god. I'm nodding here.
You are.
See, I'm a firm believer in your environment makes you what you are.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? And I think I write good songs.
Yeah.
And that's due to having experience where I live and where I grew up. Do you know what I mean?
Aye.
Say kids from here,
yeah.
Which write much better lyrics than someone from Oxford, say. Because they've got more experiences, you know, they've got more to say. There's a little bit more pain there. Yeah. And that's what music is.
I've only got to look around to know these bodies are sound. We're here looking at sights. We're not here for the fights. Fine. Keep trying to bring you down. I'll go out, I'll have a showdown. As life is still living and staying around. Looking for life, listening to sound. Guns going off all around, kids getting shot to refer to the crown. Hey kid, we've all got to die. Pick yourself up, reach for the sky.
What's happening, mate?
I remember you.
Fucking hell, man, long time no fucking see, bitch. How's it going, man?
Long time, innit?
Yeah, man, where you been?
I've been all over the place, man. What's I know you when you were about that big, man. What's come and film Knowle West, innit?
Knowle West? Hardcore, you know the score. We're back on the street, and it's nobody business, innit? You know that.
Trouble is, things don't change, do they?
No, that's the trouble, see?
In all fairness, I can't remember many kids I went to school with at Merriwood who haven't been inside or, you know.
Okay, that's what I find hard to talk to teachers, right? Because they say, have you seen so-and-so? And I have.
Yeah.
Oh, no. You know, someone's got 3 years or someone's got 4 years.
Yeah.
Or someone's been shot or stabbed. And it's hard to say to them, you know what I mean?
They're Selby. Is that Selby?
Get a drink.
You right, Paul? I don't think you can remember me, mate.
Good.
How you going, man?
It's been
a long time, innit? I recognise you from there. Yeah, this is another old friend of mine, Paul Selby.
We saw hanging around when we were nippers, man. He was a brilliant footballer, wasn't he?
Oh, he's fantastic. Brilliant footballer. He could have been. Seriously could have been like Man United material. Really was superb.
How about Chrissy Morgan and that?
Chris is inside at the moment.
Is he?
He's due, I believe, in August for parole.
No. What's your man's name?
Ivy Daniels.
You're related to us, kid. My Uncle Martin is...
Martin Goffrey. My Nan's relation.
Is Nan's relation, which is the Daniels, which Mark knows all more.
I was chatting to my Nan today and she owned about the Goffreys. Yeah. She had the colour them.
So yeah, yeah.
She said there was one of the artists around.
Do you know what? Oh, I can tell you stories about Uncle Martin. I believe in life, this is truly, I really believe that some people in life can't help it because they are possessed by the devil. There is evil in this world, you know, that you can't control. What if the honey think I'm stuck up? I tell him shut the fuck
up. So he come and stood there and he's about as far from you and he's staring, just staring at me. I thought, this man is stark raving mad. So I thought, well, I'm going to hit him now before anything happens. So I just jumped at him and hit him. And we started fighting. So he pulled out a knife and he cut all the sleeve of my suit. That made me mad now, so I got a knife and I stabbed him in the chest.
Sometimes I think about him and I can't suss him out, do you know what I mean? I can't get into his head. He's got a soft strut, but definitely in him.
And I went into this club and I looked over and Michael came over to me and said, that's my nephew. Tony's brother said, this fella's having a go at me. I said, you can go. I said, go and fuck off. I said, I hit him. But when I hit him, he made no impact on him hardly. He was massive, massive big fella. So we started fighting. And I'm hitting him, he's hitting me, and going over tables and everything. And I thought, there's no way in the world you're ever going to stop this fella. Never. You'd never stop him. So I stabbed him. And he stopped him there, all right. Oh, didn't I ever. Wallop. He went over like a Pollock steer. Wallop.
When I first went down to tape him, he taught it properly. And when he laughs sometimes, that white eye cries. And there was just one tear coming down his face there. And what it was a little bit, he was laughing, but it's almost like he's been haunted. He ain't just that it's funny. Because if you do stuff like that to people, that must, you know what I mean, when you go to bed at night, when you take someone's lung out and stuff and the things he's done. And it's almost like, that's why I believe like hell on earth.
Yes.
Are you a Godfrey?
No.
Yeah, you are, of course you're a Godfrey.
No, I'm not at all. What do you think of him?
I think he's a good geezer. He just had a hard life.
Yeah, but he's made it hard for himself, hasn't he? Good girl.
That was really hard for me to grow up. They never said Marlowe. It was, she's one of the Godfreys, and I hated that. You know, they labelled me. They didn't know who I was, what I was as a person.
I really think that the Godfreys have got a problem in their heads. I'm telling you. And I'm one in the family, and I'm telling you. Schizophrenia runs through the family. That's where my granddad's funeral was, here. So Maggie's husband. What's funny is we come here, it's me, Mark, and then all the cars. Then all my uncles started fighting each other outside the house here. They chucked all his rabbit necks in the coffin. Our nan had a fight with Martin outside here. Man, on a funeral, right? Man, didn't it? I got a brick in the head here by this little boy when I was a little kid. And I also love these two twin girls here, and one of them asked me to fight him. Last time I ever fought for a girl, that.
One of my clients asked me why her dandruff keeps coming back. The fact is, she used Head & Shoulders, so the dandruff went away. But then she went back to her cosmetic shampoo, so no wonder the dandruff came back.
Specially formulated for frequent use, Head & Shoulders gives daily protection against dandruff, which cosmetic shampoos wash away, so dandruff can come back. With Head & Shoulders, that doesn't happen.
When you're doing something right, keep doing it.
New look Head & Shoulders. Forget dandruff. Have beautiful hair every day.
Starting a family is an expensive business. Reduce the cost by conceiving on March the 25th, so your baby's birthday is on Christmas Day. For savings year after year, this money-saving tip comes from McDonald's, where remarkably an extra value meal is still just £2.88.
New Alka-Seltzer Excess. When you've had one too many.
What would she really like for Christmas? More chocolates? Or younger looking skin? Isn't that what every woman would really like for Christmas?
There's a new aftershave that's fresh. Nah, fresher than that. That's it. New White Water from Old Spice.
Fish is out of water in a fucking McDonald's in Paris.
Here we go again.
There was a big expectation for this gig in France, especially since the last one, where people, some people were raving about it and some were a little puzzled. How did you feel your audience yesterday, Ivan?
See, I don't even really think about that. I'm not trying to explain myself to anybody. You come, you like it. If you don't, you don't like it.
You mean you're too spontaneous for this kind of shitty mental thing?
Well, I don't know if it's shitty. Some people like that. I'm just saying, I feel like everybody's trying to understand what I'm doing, and what I'm doing is expressing myself. That's all I'm doing. For those who refuse to be level and exodus, I'm the devil and Satan and exorcist. Worse than a nightmare. Worse than a nightmare. That's my warming tablets as well.
Warming?
Yeah, that's a warming. See those little ones? Testosterone.
Testosterone.
Because apparently, but when you have an asthma attack, right, the quickest way to do it is steroids, to bring asthma down your way, is steroids to bring it, to get it, what was it, leveled out, to control it, right? So, steroids apparently wipe out your male hormones. Now, for instance, if I'm tired and I've got loads of stuff to do, I'll just sit down and cry. So I've got to take these hormone tablets. I mean, I'm worried it might change my lyrics, though. Because I look at all my albums, they're all... I'd see them as women's lyrics. I stand firm for a soul. Look where I come from. Yes, we still see. And it's round the corner where our shelter. Living in schizos. We're living on a skelter. If you believe our disease, then common sense says you wanna see. Then we're taking time, I could go. I could fuck most masculine men. Verbally, I could fuck with their heads, you know. I could make them look stupid. You know what I mean? I don't find them very intelligent. Men who are trying to be too male aren't very intelligent, I don't think. I think intelligence comes from having a bit of female in you. You have to be having a bit of, you know what I mean? And all man, see, I call men grunters. They're like grunters to me, they just grunt. How many masculine men, real tough guys, do you know are intelligent?
My brain thinks bomb like, bomb like. My brain thinks bomb like, bomb like, bomb like. My brain thinks bomb like. Of our appetite.
You were telling me a few minutes ago you want to disturb people, you want to do things unusual. And I read somewhere that you used to dress in women's clothes. It happened to you. Just to, you know, to
when I was about 15.
Different. You like to toy with archetypes and to
that's
show
insecurity.
People how narrow-minded they are?
No, it's insecurity. It's striving for attention. That's why I'm an artist. No way you're better seeking attention when you're with a posse of boys, you know what I mean? And we're all lads, quite laddie, and I'm wearing a dress, and there's 8 kids in trainers in baseball caps, and I've got a dress on a baseball cap. And sometimes it's a challenge.
Yeah.
Because if you're quite vulnerable in a skirt, you're very vulnerable, you know what I mean? So you go out to a club or walk down the street with a sarong on and try and be a tough guy. I think more men should be made to wear this sort of thing, because then I think we might lose some of this tough guy stuff. See, I've lost loads of weight. I've lost about 10 stone because of my broken neck. That's why my body doesn't look its usual self. Like a Bruce Lee sort of body I'd like.
Is he one of your heroes?
Yeah. He's just wicked. He's an aura. Energy, that's energy, see? People don't understand the energy. It's nothing to do with skills, talent. But music got nothing to do with skills, talent, energy. It's a gift and no one controls it.
Mm-hmm.
those movies. They say squeeze, never put it. Muscles wrap round the bullet. Me, I say you be brought in tall. Okay, let me make a phone call.
This is the boring time, this is the turn. There's nothing to do until the gig.
Fuck around with my privacy.
See, these hormones are making me grow hairs. I've got hairs on my fucking chest. I don't know if I like it. I mean, I don't know if I want to be a man. I'm quite decided. But in the work I'm doing, I can't afford to be emotional like that and break down and give in like that and just start crying. I can't afford that. I have to be quite aggressive. Picture, don't we? Yeah. He's very normal. In the beginning, I'm not into smiling, see. Now I am for the cameras and things. Because I want to be taken very seriously. You know what I mean? But I think most people, photographers, the pose they always ask for is, see this one here, all right? Like a mass murderer or something. That's like when it's all gangster. But anyway, they always try and get me to do that one. Like.
Mean and nasty.
Yeah. Fucking hell, look at the difference between there and there.
So which one feels more like you?
Sometimes I have to read things two or three times. Sometimes I see a front cover and I have to look at it. And I still think, I can't believe this, this is mad. This is like weird, you know what I mean? So I still don't believe it's happening, I think, you know what I mean? Yeah. It's hard to believe it, you know what I mean? I feel like there's different people. There's a kid who went to Marywood School, Adrian Falls, and there's this kid, Tricky. And now they're like a bit mixed up and I don't know what's going on. Now
bears fruit next as we join Tricky live in concert. That's in a couple of minutes.